Okay, good morning, everyone. It's Tuesday, August 6th. I'm John Weigell here with Sara Friedman, and this is the Hustle Daily Show. The Paris Olympics and Taylor Swift's Eras Tour are just two examples of the booming sports and music tourism industries. Traveling for events has become extremely popular among Gen Zers and millennials who prefer paying for experiences rather than material goods. This trend has become so big that these industries are projected to reach $1.5 trillion by 2032. So how did sports and music tourism get so big, and why is this happening right now? We'll get to that in a bit, but first let's give you the hits and headlines in business and tech. First up to Elon Musk. Elon Musk's Neuralink implanted its device into a second patient's brain. Musk, while appearing on Lex Friedman's podcast, said it went, quote, extremely well. Speaking of Elon Musk, he's revisiting allegations that Sam Altman manipulated him into co-founding OpenAI. Musk's federal court lawsuit says he was deceived into joining the company by being told it would remain a nonprofit. Well, that didn't happen. Up next, Grok, the startup producing chips to power AI models, raised $640 million in a new funding round, bringing its total to over $1 billion with a $2.8 billion valuation. Maybe that'll be some competition for Nvidia down the road. Over to my favorite place to get meatballs. IKEA must pay $566 million for allegedly deleting evidence in an ongoing class action age discrimination lawsuit. The retailer is accused of deleting employees' emails after being asked to produce them. That's a big no-no. And finally, Mars Incorporated is in talks to acquire Kellogg's spinoff Kellanova, which would add companies like Pringles, Cheez-Its, Pop-Tarts, and more to its already gigantic candy empire. Kellanova shares grew 22% in pre-market trading to anticipate this. Okay, on to the main story today. Many people have traveled for a big event like the Olympics or a blowout concert like, you know, Taylor Swift's Eras Tour. And thus, the industries of sports and music tourism are skyrocketing to the highest of highs right now. So, Sara, how much money is this travel generating?
Quite a bit. The sports and music tourism economy is projected to hit $1.5 trillion, that's with a T, by 2032, according to new research from Collinson International and per Bloomberg. So that is a very big number. And so if it feels like everyone on your social media feeds is in Europe, it's because they just might be.
Because they probably are and spent a lot of money to do it. And, you know, you cite a lot of kinds of events here. Of course, the Paris Olympics is going to generate huge income and every Olympics is going to be like that. But we've also had these large-scale international tours like the Taylor Swift tour, and also Formula One has gained sufficient popularity in the past few years. So this isn't exactly hard to think of, but $1.5 trillion is a pretty insane amount. Could you break that down for me a little bit in each category?
Yeah, so far and away, this is coming from sports tourism. So that alone was valued at $564.7 billion in 2023. And just sports tourism is estimated to reach $1.33 trillion in the next 8 years. So most of that number is coming down to just sports, which I think is really incredible. And then music tourism, which is currently valued at $6.6 billion, is expected to more than double and reaching $13.8 billion in that same time frame. So sports is really carrying that amount here, but music as well, more than doubling, that's a pretty significant gain.
Yeah, I guess a big point here is the growth of the kinds of events that you can go to. Because sports, as you mentioned, is really, really pulling that wagon throughout this whole thing. And maybe that's attributed to sports like Formula One gaining more popularity because, for example, World Cup's coming up in a few years, and we already know that's going to spark a lot of tourism dollars, but maybe more niche interests have kind of come up to the fold.
Yeah, I think that's definitely part of it. Just the way that social media and the internet works these days, I think people are exposed to a lot of sports that they might not have been before and become fans of these things. So in the survey of the 8,500 people who answered these questions. 83% said that they've flown to a sporting event, and 71% said that they've flown to a concert either in the past 3 years or plan to in the next 12 months. So the majority of people are getting on a plane to go to a stadium to either watch a show or a concert or a sporting event. That's, you know, most people at this point. So it's pretty interesting. It's becoming much more popular. And again, it's noteworthy because people are getting on planes and, you know, traveling across continents to do this. They're not just going to their local stadium to watch a game.
Right. And there's a lot more involved than just going to the event and going home in these scenarios, right? There's the whole paying for your flight, getting there. But what kind of expenses are associated, or are people kind of staying even longer for these concerts and events when they get to this destination?
Yeah, that's exactly what's going on. So 80% said that they stay 1 to 3 days after the event, and 77% said they arrive at least 1 to 2 days before. So that's a big deal for local economies. People are flying in early, staying late, extending their trips, and are likely, you know, exploring the towns around the stadiums and taking part in other tourism activities. So it's much more than just the ticket for a single game.
Yeah. And, you know, there has to also be a lot in here about the spending that happens during these events, because you pay for your ticket, but then you pay for everything leading up to it, and then you pay for everything after it. So how much are people paying for example, the sporting events?
Yeah, so there's already some big numbers coming in. So in 2023, the Formula One Grand Prix brought $1.5 billion to the Las Vegas economy in November. That's 50% more than the entire Super Bowl, just to put that into context. The Paris Summer Olympics caused Airbnb bookings to go up 133% year over year. And international tourists are estimated to spend around $5,000 for hotel, airfare, and event tickets per person. So these are big numbers, and the list goes on and on. Taylor Swift fans drove airfare sales up 45% year over year. That was just through United for during concert dates during her tour. And even youth sports tourism is said to have generated $39.7 billion in direct spending, with a total economic impact of $91.8 billion. So, you know, we're not messing around here. This is not just a little cash on the side. This is making kind of a massive dent on local economies.
Yeah. And a lot of younger people, it seems, are the ones spending all this money. Are Gen Zers and millennials, you think, more likely to go to these things, spend this money, and create that experience?
I think so. I think we talk about it in many different contexts in the articles that we're writing, but it's been kind of proven time and again that Gen Zers and millennials are more interested in spending money on experiences rather than tangible objects. So I think this is perfectly in line with that trend. If you kind of have saved up and have a little money to spend on the side, that you might be more likely to book a trip around a sporting event than you would to buy a really nice watch. So I think this is just part of that broader trend. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And there's also another story that you cite in here from Yahoo about how the majority of Gen Zers and millennials, 60% in a survey, said that they would rather spend their money on experiences rather than save for their retirement. So them's big numbers right there. And that could be a lot of what's moving this amount.
Yeah, I don't know if we should be scared about that, or if that's, you know, a sign of taking advantage of all that life has to offer. But yes, this is a generation that's very interested in living in the moment and having experiences with peers and friends, even if that comes at the expense of a 401k, possibly.
Yeah, for example, like I have a bunch of friends who, of course, have traveled to see concerts. Strangely enough, one of the biggest arguments that I've gotten is that a friend of mine was going to see Beyonce, wanted to see Beyonce in New York. Tickets were way too expensive. So he said to himself, okay, why don't I go see Beyonce in Stockholm? Because the ticket is cheaper, but with flight, airfare, hotel, it'll be about the same price as a ticket to see Beyonce in New York. So why wouldn't I make a trip out of it? So maybe that's even part of the reasoning here.
Yeah, I mean, that's concert math. If it adds up, it works. And if you get a free trip out of it, you can, you know, kind of tell yourself it's free if you crunch the numbers in a certain way.
Yeah, right. Right. I really enjoy the introduction of the term concert math today. I think that's going to do a lot for us. All right. Thank you very much, Sarah. And that's going to do it for us today, everybody. Thanks for tuning into the Hustle Daily Show. We're a proud part of the HubSpot Podcast Network. Our editor today is Robert Hartwig, and our executive producer is Darren Clark. We've got a lot more tech and business coverage in our newsletter. If you're not subscribed, go get signed up at thehustle.co/email, and we'll see you tomorrow.